in the building, please keep your children with you at all times. Thank you for flying with your parents.
Looking east, away from the city, you can see another impressive feat of British engineering, the Thames Barrier. It's one of the largest movable flood barriers in the world, and has been protecting London for more than 30 years.
The original design to idea was to protect against the 1 in 1,000 floods in the year 2030. So they used the data they had available and they projected that into the future. They built extra safety margins in, and it looks like we'll be okay till 2070. The barrier is comprised of 10 gates, the largest of which is 3,300 tonnes, approximately a third of an Eiffel Tower's worth of metal in each one, and they rotate into position. The barrier protects against an area of land with about 1.25 million people. If you're walking along the south bank, if you could imagine another 3.5 metres of concrete obstructing your view, that's what the barrier protects against.
The Port of London has been a centre for trade since Roman times. By the 1800s, it was the busiest port in the world. A series of huge enclosed docks were built, surrounded by high walls, to protect cargo from thieves and pirates. The docks stretch from Tower Bridge to City Airport, and the Museum of London Docklands is preserving the history of this crucial trading hub.
The building we're sitting in is built in 1802. When it was built, it was the biggest warehouse in the world. The Romans first settled on the Thames, and obviously the Vikings came after the Romans. And all throughout history, there's always been lots and lots of trade. There was loads and loads of privacy. In actual fact, there's a gibbet cage in the museum. And there wasn't executed in a gibbet cage, and you was hung, and then you would have been cut down, and then you would have been put into the gibbet cage. And there was a councilship on the client, and it was like, if you tell them, you behave yourself, well, what this is going to happen to you. Whereas it's played a very important part in the war, because if you look at the infrastructure, then you can't get the slow position out. Now, you can imagine the velocity of the bombing, and sometimes you had the sugar going up and catching light, and then at the very end of the buildings, you had the rum going up and catching, and it would actually make sleg toffee. And all the children would be around the following morning, scooping it up, taking it home. You can come to this area, you can walk around, and you can see where all these things happen.
The East End docks have undergone major redevelopment in recent decades. Royal Victoria Dock is now home to XL London, one of the largest exhibition centres in Europe. King George V Dock has become the grounds for City Airport. The Royal Albert Dock to the north of the airport is next for redevelopment.
Royal Albert Dock used to be the commercial centre for the British Empire. Beef used to come from Argentina and other places, and it went on trains into London. But this was the meat store when the meat first came off the ships. This is going to be an Asian business port. Companies from Asia will be able to set up their headquarters and trade into Europe. The city airport will allow business people to travel to and from European cities right here into Royal Albert Dock. Business leaders will be able to attend meetings in Paris and within 2 hours be back at their desks here in London. And this and we're going to this area really hard to get really